Hi, welcome to the Real Praise Ministries. I'm Nanette Langford. Today's title is Dependence on Jesus. But before we get into the lesson, I would like to open up in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, I want to take the opportunity to thank you for this day. For this is a day that you have made, Father God, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Father God, open up my heart and open up my mind. Let me, Lord, decrease that you may increase in me. Lord, I pray that everyone under the sound of my voice, Father God, will not only be blessed from this word, God, but they may examine their hearts, God. And we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that they may just lean on you, Father God, and try to truly appreciate your word for their lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before I actually take a scripture, I would like to read something to you. The desire to act independently apart from me springs from the root of pride and self-sufficiency. But my deepest desire for you is that you learn to depend on me in every situation. I moved heaven and earth to accomplish this purpose. But you must collaborate with me in this training. Teaching you would be simple if I negated my power over you for your free will, and that would just overwhelm you. However, I love you too much to withdraw the godlike privilege I bestowed upon you as my image bearers. Use your freedom wisely. By relying on me constantly, thus enjoying my presence and my peace. Amen. Did you know that when you totally depend on God, basically what you're saying is, God, I cannot do this on my own. I need your provisions for my life. I need your direction, Lord. It's so important that we understand that because once we start to go on our own way, and what I mean when I say go on our own way is we start to think that we're in complete control of our lives. We're in complete control of our thought life. But the truth is, beloved, we're not. And the sooner we learn to depend on Jesus, we will not only appreciate the privileges of Jesus, but we'll also understand the reward that is bestowed upon us as a result of our dependence on Him. I'm going to take a scripture from Genesis, and it's going to be in chapter 1, but verses 26 and 27. And it reads as follows. God said, "Let us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, make mankind in our image, after our own likeness, and let them have complete authority over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and the beasts, and over all the earth and over everything that creepeth upon the earth." Verse 7. So God created man in his own image. And in the image and likeness of God, he created him, male and female. He created them. Praise Jesus. Now, this lesson that I just read from you has been taken from the Amplified Bible. And throughout this period of me ministering to you, it will be coming solely from the Amplified Bible for those that just tuned in. When we think of being in the likeness of God, that means that we have to change the way that we think. We have to change the way that we do things. And ultimately, we just have to say to ourselves, God, teach me how to be like you. Show me through your word how to think like you. But in order for God to do that, we have to take the time to go to the word, which is the Bible, and we have to read it, we have to meditate on it, And we have to do what it tells us to do. Because God loves us so much that he's always going to honor us because he's a God of love. And no matter what we do, and no matter what choices that we make, God is always going to love us because he's a loving father. But also be mindful, even though God is a loving father, there will always be consequences for the choices that you and I make. So please be mindful of that. Yes, God loves us. Yes, there's nothing that we can do to stop God from loving us and giving us the benefits that he has for us. However, please be mindful that whatever choice that you make in life, there will be consequences. If you do something that's going to be right and pleasing to the Father, then he's going to honor that. But if you do something that's not pleasing to the Father, there are always consequences. However, he still loves you in spite. Let's talk about how sometimes when we decide that, you know, I've tried the Word and I've tried the Lord, but things are not working out. But did you not know that it is so important to wait on the Lord? And as we wait, to be of good courage, and as you wait, to thank him in advance, even though we don't see what's happening. Your Heavenly Father is always working beyond the scenes. Just because we cannot see what he's doing right at that moment does not mean that he is not moving and working on your behalf. Once you make your request known unto the Lord, he is moving. Did you know that God loves you so much that whenever you make a request to God, and please be mindful, it has to be according to the will of God. It must be according to his will for your life. Because a lot of times we want to go to God, and when we go to him, we have so many things going on within us. There are a lot of hidden things that people may not see, but your Heavenly Father, he sees it and he knows about it. Because remember, we are his image bearers. So that means his image lives inside of us. Because remember, when we read in Genesis chapter 1, it clearly told us in verse 26 and 27 that God said, let us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, make mankind in our image. So he already told you and I that we are already in his image. So we already have everything that we need because God already placed it in us when he gave us his image. It's up to you and I to operate in that. You have to operate in it so that people can see that God's image lives inside of you. But if you don't take the time to read your word, you don't take the time to go to God daily and say, Lord, I need you. I can't do this without you. Lord, come and live inside of me, Father God, that we may commune with one another. Now, does that mean that you're not going to miss the mark sometimes? Well, the goal is always to do it God's way. Because of our frailty and our insufficiencies, sometimes we may miss the mark, but Jesus still loves us all the same because he knows that there's really no good thing in us. And that's why we need the word as a mirror to show us what we look like on the inside. Because remember, it starts on the inside and it works its way out. It's never on the outside. Because people can look at the inside and say to you, well, you know, there are some things that just doesn't set right. Especially when we say that we're ambassadors for God and we're living in his image. You know, sometimes people can see certain characteristics in us that doesn't necessarily exemplify the image of Christ. But all too often, we look at the outer exterior. And the outer exterior is just what it is. What you see is what you pretty much get. But those are all superficial things. Yes, it's important for us to look presentable and carry ourselves in a Christ-like manner. But the key here is the inner man, the inner essence. That's what the focus on today is with the dependency on God. We're looking from the inside out. Because remember, God knows where we are. He knows what we feel. He knows how we feel. But most importantly, He knows what's in us. And we may be able to show certain characteristics to mankind, but God knows all those little hidden and secret places that man can't see. This is where we need to depend on God. And this is where we need to say, Father, there are some things in me that I know only you can help me with. But you first have to recognize it. Because if you don't recognize where you are and what you are without the dependence on Christ, then you'll go on through this life deceiving and being deceived by the adversary, which is the devil, the evil one. So I always want to be clear when I express these things to you, because we don't want to be controlled by the world system. We don't want to always walk around being deceived and also deceiving other people, because the truth is, if we don't know the truth, then we will deceive other people. And we don't want the enemy to have a foothold in our lives like that. That's why we have to read the Word of God, and we have to remember what the Word of God says to us. So when the enemy comes in, we can take the Word of God and pull that thought into captivity with the Word of God. But you don't know what the enemy is doing in your life if you can't first recognize his tactics and the little things that he does to deceive you and to get you entangled into little demonic things that God never intended for you to get entangled in. So understanding the importance of the dependency on Jesus, who is our Lord and Savior, is to go to the Word, find out what the Word says, not only be a hearer of the Word, but be a doer of the Word so it can manifest through your lifestyle. Let's take another scripture. We're going to go to John 15, 4 and 8. Now, John chapter 15, verses 4 through 8 says, dwell in me, and I will dwell in you. Live in me, and I will live in you. Just as no branch can bear no fruit of itself without abiding, the vine neither can bear fruit unless you abide in me. I am the vine and you are the branches. Whoever lives in me and I in him bears much abundant fruit. However, apart from me, you can bear nothing. If a person does not dwell in me, he is thrown out like a broke off branch and withered. Such branches are gathered up and thrown into fire, there where they are burned. But if you live in me and abide in me, and my word remains in you, and you continue to live in your heart, the word that dwells upon you, whatever you will ask, it shall be done for you. When you bear much fruit, my Father is honored and glorified. And you show and prove yourselves to be true followers of me. That's the dependence on Christ. We have to glorify our Father. His word has to abide in us. We have to abide in him. We have to be honest with ourselves. Because as he stated in verse 5, he said, I am the vine and you are the branches. So we know what a vine is. And we know what branches are. But if we're not hooked up to the vine, then we're broken off. Therefore, we're no good for anything. So we have to be careful. We have to make sure that we're rooted in the Word of God. We have to make sure that we're connected to the vine. Because in that vine gives us life. In that vine keeps us connected to God. But I also want to say, you have to want to be connected. Because a lot of times people don't want to be connected. Because being connected as a branch to the vine, that means you got to break off all that stuff that's not godly. And a lot of times we don't want to grow. We want to stay where we are. But you have to grow in Christ. You have to be mature saints in the Lord. That's the whole point of depending on God. And growing daily in your dependency on Him. Because it's not just good enough to have head knowledge. You got to have heart knowledge too. It has to be rooted in you. And you have to want more of God. Because He loves you so much, He is never going to let you go on your own way. However, He's not going to put Himself on you. That's why He gives us free will to choose. Because He loves us so much, He wants you to come on your own free will. But He also wants you to be sincere when you come. Because you got to keep in mind, God, our Heavenly Father, knows what's inside of us. You can't come wavering. You can't be double-minded. You can't be serving God when it's convenient for you. No. You have to serve God every day, all the time, when things are going well, when they're not going so well. You have to say, my hope and dependence is in Jesus. That's where you have to be. And please be mindful, there are going to be things that are going to try to shake your faith. But that's when you take up your shield. You pick up your word, which is your weapon. And you know the Word of God says that we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. But you got to be in Christ. Because it says we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. So the emphasis is there is through. Because we can't do nothing on our own. You have to be in Christ Jesus. As the word says, we have to abide in Him and He has to abide in us. So once God's word comes and lives in us, all the old things are going away. Behold, all have become new. We are a new creation. So that means as a new creation, our thinking is supposed to line up with the word of God. Our talk is supposed to line up with the word of God. We are supposed to speak blessings over people. When we speak a word, we have to speak with authority in the name of Jesus. And then you have to stand your ground and you have to know that God is your strong tower. He is your vindicator. But you must go to the word of God to know what it is that is in you. Don't you know you have power to overcome anything that the enemy sends your way? But see, what the enemy does, he'll you see, because he has peeped into your future. And he ain't trying to have you excelling in the word of God. He ain't trying to have you preach the word. He ain't trying to have you teach the word. But let me tell you something. The devil is a defeated foe. He is a liar and the truth is not in him. And he knows that his time is short. He knows his time is winding up. So he is trying to deceive as many people as he can. But see, we know as Christians, we know as believers, that as long as we stand on the promises of God, praise Jesus, we have the victory. And don't faint in your mind. When things are coming up against you and you're not clear what to do, you got to go to your word. Go to the word of God. That is your strength. That is your anchor. This is where you get your stability from. This is where your hope is in. This is where your confidence is in. And you got to keep on pressing and leaning toward Jesus. And you got to keep running and moving in the things of God. See, because the enemy messes with your head. Yeah, the battle's in the mind. See, the enemy likes to get in your head and he likes to say, oh, God told you that you could have this and you had that. Why that didn't happen and he promised you this. You know, the devil's a liar. All he does is pervert the truth of the word of God. But if you don't read your word, you don't know what the devil's trying to do. You must get in this word and you must read his word and you must say to God, Lord, I love you. Lord, I may not always get it right. I might always not always think right. I might not always act right. I may not always do right. But God, you know that my heart panteth after you. You know that I love you, Lord. And I want to get right. I want to be right. I want to think right. I want to talk right. In the name of Jesus. But you also have to do the things that are required so that God can show you what you need to change in your life. This is important. You got to get rid of the pride. You got to get rid of the arrogancy. Because see, as believers, we're not even, these things ain't even supposed to be named among us. There should be no pride. There should be no arrogancy. We should show humility. We should love on one another. So when we do go to witness to the world, they will receive us in the name of Jesus. Because when you go out there as an evangelist, you have to go in the name of Jesus. Because if you go any other way, it's not going to work. Because it's not about us. We have to keep the perspective. It is about the glory of God. It is about kingdom building for the Lord. You have to have that attitude when you're dealing with people that don't know God. And remember, we're learning every day too. Don't get so high-minded that you think you can't learn. Remember, we are learning every day too as believers. Every day God is pruning and purging because we are not perfect. And if you think you're perfect, then I must say, beloved, you're deceived. Because there is none good but the Father. Let's take another scripture. And once again, it's called coming from the Amplified Bible. Let's take a scripture from Proverbs. Now, this lesson will be taken from Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. And it reads as follows. Lean on, trust in, and be confident in the Lord with all your heart and with all your mind, and do not rely on your own insight or understanding. So what is he saying to us here? What is God saying to us when he say, don't lean on your own insight and on your own understanding? Don't lean on all the things that you put in your mind and purpose in your own heart. You got to go see what the word says about that. Because remember, earlier in the segment, I said everything that we do don't always line up with God's provision for your life. It has to be according to his will for your life. But if you're in the word and you're trusting God, if you're leaning on God and relying on God and doing what the word tells you to do, you'll know that you're in his provision. But if one minute you're leaning in the word of God and reading it, and then soon something go wrong, then you going toward back to your old way of doing things. No, it just doesn't work like that. You have to purpose in your mind, my dependency and dependence is on the Father. Because see, he knows where he's trying to take you. He knows what needs to come out of you, and he knows what he needs to work out in you so that he can work through you to get his provisions done, not only for your life, but for the lives of other people that you're going to touch. Because I always will go back to, we have to remember, it's not about us. It's about Jesus. See, a lot of times we got to think about what we're thinking about. Too often we think about it's us. Get your mind off yourself and put your mind on Jesus. Because if you put your mind on yourself too much, you're going to be worried about what's not going right for you and what you want for you and why it ain't working out for you. No, it ain't about you. It ain't about me. It's about Jesus, the Son of God. Once we get that perspective straight, then the rest is pretty much smooth sailing. So we have to always have as our focal point, our focus has to be this. Father God, what is it that I need to get better with? Because you have to examine yourself. You ever notice that sometimes it's easy for us to point out, you know, the faults in other people? First of all, we really shouldn't do that because the Bible clearly tells us, judge not, lest we be judged. So you want to be mindful of that. You don't want to judge people because we're all growing and we're all working towards the things of God. And as we work towards the things of God, we have to remember it is about God. It's all of Him and it's none of us. Because the glory belongs to Him, not to you and I. The glory belongs to the Father. He came and took away everything that we will ever need, everything that we would ever experience. He paid it all so that we may have eternal life. And we can have it right here. We can have it right here, but we must go to the Word and we must do what it tells us to do. To read it is one thing, but we need to understand what we're reading. And we need to do what it says to do after we read it. Thank you, Jesus, for your provisions. Thank you, Lord, for your strength. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you, Lord, for your love. Thank you, Lord, for your kindness. Thank you, Lord, for your power. Remember your dependence on Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you for all those under the sound of my voice, God. Lord, I pray, Lord, that somebody was healed and set free today in the name of Jesus, Father God. I pray, God, that they will take this lesson, God, and just run into things of God, Lord. And when the enemy comes up against them, Lord, that they would take that thing and pull it into captivity with the word of God. Lord, I thank you for loving us more, Lord, than we could ever understand, Lord. Lord, we're going to lean on you, Lord. We're going to rely on you. We're going to stand on your promise, no matter what it looks like, God. We know that we are more than a conqueror, Lord God. And we thank you for loving us in spite of our faults. Until we meet again, Lord, I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll see you next time on the Real Praise Ministries. If you have any prayer requests, please dial 215-253-9744. And one of our prayer partners will be glad to have prayer with you. Thank you.